I took this photo on Wellington Street here in Barcelona, and I wanted to catch the tram or trolley car or however it's called passing by, and I had to wait until almost 10 o'clock to get the shot that I wanted, and it was really difficult to take the picture because it was a really low angle, and it was not easy. And actually, I just wanted to get back home without any kind of pictures because I thought it was not easy to take it. And I came back with the photo that you've seen, and just I tried to edit it just to see if I could fix it, and this is what I got. The lights are a bit burnt, but anyways. So when you open the raw file, let me open it, you will find it, as I said, on my website. You will open it, you will already have it edited because it has the XMP file and as well, so you will get it edited like this. And if you take a look at the edits that I made, you will find everything here. But if you want to edit it your way, you can reset everything and just press and hold the Alt key and click reset, and you will reset everything, or simply delete that XMP file and you can edit it again yourself. I'm gonna open it here. I'm not gonna re-edit it here in Camera Raw. Also, if you open this in Lightroom, you will get the same edits because the XMP file can be read by Lightroom as well. So I'm gonna open as object, pressing the Shift key and click Open Object. That way I open it as a smart object. You can see that the picture is not straight. It's not even close to being straight. But I'm gonna straighten it here in Photoshop because in Camera Raw, I don't like how it works. So I'm gonna use that to straighten it. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, it's not really straight like that. I like it more. So after Camera Raw, what I did is I wanted to change the color of the ground. So I used the Hue Saturation Adjustment layer, and I checked the colorize option, and I set the hue to 219 and saturation to 45. Then I set the blend mode of this to overlay. Now it looks really strong, so we have to use this layer mask. I'm gonna deactivate this for a second and use the quick selection tool over the image to just select the ground like that. And with the Alt key, I can remove the selection from areas that I don't need. Like these ones over there and over here as well. So once you have your selection, reactivate the hue saturation and fill it with black and then invert it. Now, this is the selection that I have. Now, in order to smoothen the edges, you can, let me zoom in a bit more like that. You can double click on the layer mask and use the feather option. If you don't have this option on your Photoshop, it's because you have an older version, and all you need to do is apply some Gaussian blur on the layer mask. Actually, if I set it on full screen, you can do that. If you press Alt and click on the layer mask, you can see what I did is simply blurring the layer mask, and that's it. That's how I got this color. Now, let's move on. And the next thing that I did is I desaturated the sky using another hue saturation adjustment. I'm gonna invert the layer mask now to have it black. And what I will do is, I'm gonna deactivate it now. I'm gonna use this hand icon and sample that color over there. This will select my blues from this drop-down list, and you can see the selection over here. I'm gonna restrict it a bit more, only on the blues, because I don't want to affect the cyans. And I'm gonna drop the saturation of this. Now simply move this around until you can see, take a look at the sky, just move the selection until the saturation is gone. Now, reactivate the layer mask. By the way, you can activate and deactivate layer masks pressing and holding the shift key and clicking on the layer mask itself. Now, I'm gonna get the brush tool. I'm gonna use a soft brush and just paint with white over the sky there. It was too blue for my taste, but if you like it like that, you can leave it blue. For me, it was too saturated. I'm gonna bring back some of that saturation, but the reason why I reduced it almost completely is because I wanna see when I paint, I wanna see the effect. And now I'm gonna reopen this and go back to the blues and just recover some of that. You can even change the hue if you want to, but I'm gonna leave it to zero. Okay, now let's move on. And the next thing I did is some cleaning using a new layer. I'm gonna name it clean and simply use the spot healing brush and make sure you have all layers selected. And I'm gonna use a soft brush and just sample from here and just clean the image on places that you don't want, that you don't like. Like that, maybe here as well. I have the pen pressure on, which I don't like. Also, maybe these bags over here. These ones are a bit trickier to hide, so be careful. Just remove the parts that are more distracting to you, and that's it. Probably this one over here as well, but be careful with the lines. Like that, and maybe that one there and this one here. And that's it. I'm gonna stop here. Probably this part over there. And take a look before and after. Just clean the most distracting elements here in the foreground. Now, the next thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a new layer on overlay. And I'm gonna name it Lights one, and I'm gonna use the brush tool. And here I'm gonna use a 50%. If you use 50% here, desaturated, set this on overlay. If you paint with the brush, nothing will happen because it's a neutral color. But if you have something brighter than 50%, say 60, you'll start to brighten things when you paint. And I used this to enhance some of the lights. I'm gonna drop the opacity and the flow to 50%. You can use the keyboard shortcuts to do this. If you press 5 on the numeric keypad on your keyboard, you will change the opacity. And if you press and hold the shift key and press 6, for example, you will change the flow. So that's a quick way of changing that. And with this low opacity brush, I'm gonna enhance some of the highlights here. On the walls over there as well, and I'm gonna paint over the lights as well a bit. Now, for the lights, you can, for this colored lights, you can use another technique on a new layer. I'm gonna name it Lights 2, and you can use the color dodge. This is perfect if you want to enhance lights. So I'm gonna start with the red lights. I'm gonna use a red color. But you have to use really dark tones for this because otherwise it's gonna be too strong. And I'm gonna use an opacity of 50 and flow 50 as well. And simply paint over the lights that you wanna enhance. It's too strong. Well, it's not too strong, it's too... The brush was too big. I just wanna paint over the light. Over there and this one here. Like that. And for the blue one, I'm gonna get another tone. Like that. For this white lights, you can also use, for example, an orange light, an orange color like that, and just paint over those. And that's it. You can paint with that lights on some other places of your image if you want to give them some color. but for me that's okay. I'm gonna go back to the lights one on, which is on overlay, because I wanted to enhance the light here on the tree. Just really basic painting, don't think that this is a digital painting, but let me show you the before and after. And just brighten up the highlights a bit. And now let's start with the colors. I'm gonna add a color lookup. For this, you need at least Photoshop CS6. If you have a version that is previous to CS6, you will not be able to add this color lookup adjustment because they introduced it in Photoshop CS6. So here I'm gonna use a preset, which you will find on my website as well. It's a DK79, this one. And I like the color that it gives to the image. It's too strong, so I'm gonna drop the opacity. First, I'm gonna change the blend mode to color, and this also gives it some gives back some of the contrast originally on the image. And I'm gonna drop the opacity to 55%. And you can see we already start to get some really nice effect. Let me show you where we started with and where we are at right now. So let's move on and add another color lookup. And this time I'm gonna use the drop blues. This comes with Photoshop. So it's a preset that already comes with this adjustment. And I'm gonna leave it on normal and I'll drop the opacity to 50%. Now, the next thing I'm gonna do is add some curves because I wanna add some contrast. I don't know what this happens here, this square here. It happened when I made the Spanish version of the tutorial, and I don't know what it appears there. Anyways, let's open the curves, and here I added 5 points. So it's something a bit more complex. I'm gonna add the first point, and I'm gonna give you the values. So input 46 and output 39. A second point with input 82 and output 80. A third point with input 118 and output 126. And another one with input 170 and output 176. And a new point with input 205 and output 215. So this is the curve that I have. How I came up with this? Well, just simply tweaking, watching the image, and I wanted to increase the contrast a bit. So this is how I got this. Now, I'm gonna leave it like that. The next adjustment that I'm gonna add is an exposure adjustment. Here, I just changed the offset to 0.0073. Okay, and enter. Looks like nothing changed. Okay, here, like that. This will add a sort of a faded effect on the image. And we're gonna recover some of that contrast, okay? But I liked how it looked right now. Because the next thing we're gonna do is go to Camera Raw. Now, remember that all the adjustments that you created here, you can save this as a 3D LUT for other night pictures, for example. I just published a tutorial a few days ago showing you how to save this look on a 3D LUT, so you can use it with the color lookup. So you can use the same look on a color lookup preset. And I have a tutorial, I'm gonna give you the link to that. You'll find it under the video. You'll find it on my website as well and on YouTube. So once we're done with that, I'm gonna create a stamp with Shift Alt Command E. Or Shift Alt Control E on a PC. You can also Control A, and this will select the whole canvas. Go to Edit, Copy Special, or Copy Merged, depending on your Photoshop version, and then just Edit Paste, and that's it. So with this new layer created, basically what it does is just it takes all the layers and it merges into a new layer on top of everything. I'm gonna turn it into a smart object just in case. I like to work that way when I use Camera Raw. And now I'm going to filter and choose Camera Raw filter. Now, if you don't have Photoshop CC, you will not have this filter here, but you can still use it. All you need to do is go to File, use Save As, and save your image as a TIFF file. So simply go to Format and choose TIFF. Where it is? Right here, choose TIFF and save it on your desktop or whatever you want to save it. And then open it back with Photoshop, and by default, it should open it in Camera Raw. And when you open it in Camera Raw, you should get something like what I'm having here. Maybe a bit different depending on your Photoshop version and depending on your Camera Raw version, but something like this. Now, the next thing I'm gonna do is change the basic module here. So I have the highlights. I'm gonna give the values that I have, but you can edit it your own way. I have the highlights to minus 18, whites minus 24, vibrance 26, and saturation to 8. Next, let's go to the split tone, and I have on the highlights hue 156, saturation 11, and on the shadows we have 267 and saturation to 13. It's a bit too saturated, so I'm gonna go back and saturate things if I need to. Here on the basic module, I'm gonna drop the vibrance back to, let's say, 15. And here I'm gonna change the balance maybe. Well, actually, I'm gonna leave it to zero, the balance. And on the FX, I can add some vignette here if I want to, midpoint, and I'm gonna increase the highlights 100% to keep the highlights. And here there's one thing you can do here on the camera calibration. You can use these colors to change the tones of your image. See that? If I want to make it more orangey looking, or I can change the look from here as well. You can make some really cool things. It's just like using the split channel mixer, but in an easier way. I'm gonna leave it like that. Probably increase the clarity to, let's say, yeah, actually had it to 29, the clarity. It gives a lot more contrast to the image. I'm gonna click OK, and you will see the before and after Camera Raw. Take a look. Before Camera Raw and after Camera Raw. And I'm gonna show you the original image that we started with. We started from this to this, and actually this is not even the original image, because we edited it already in Camera Raw, and this is the final result. So that's all. That's how I created this night shot. That's how I edited it. As I said, it's a pretty bad shot. Usually I don't get such bad images, but as I said, I was not planning for that shot. I just took it because I had the lights here, so I wanted to. It was more like a test shot than anything else. So I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you liked this tutorial. I would like to see your edits and your night photos. So if you use Instagram, use the hashtag PSDBox so I can see your images. And also on Facebook, you can use the same hashtag and I can find your pictures there. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next tutorial.